a wedgie, you know. The gait belt has to be on for transfers, unless it's contraindicated by a medical issue. But remember this, your families are watching you. They are going to mirror and mimic your behavior. And if they're seeing you use a gait belt, they're going to be more likely to use a gait belt. And falls are just too much of a potential. They are too much of a possibility. So use your gait belt. So if you had a pot of boiling water on the stove and you were going to move it from the stove to the chopping block, you know, you wouldn't just wrap your arms around that pot. You grab the handles. Well, this gait belt is your handles. Now, choking. Now, this does not take the place of taking CPR. This is just a little review, okay? And I highly advise you, if you are, you know, you do not have CPR certification, even if your facility agency doesn't require it, I still would recommend it, okay? I would highly recommend it. Current statistics are right now that out of 100 Americans, 5 to 10 of them are at one time in their lifetime going to do CPR or the Heimlich on someone, or even higher statistics than that even. So it's good to basically know what to do. But in the Heimlich, you're reaching around the person, you're making your fist, you're putting it on, you know, you're getting your landmark, the belly button, you're putting it just a little bit above the belly button, reaching around and coming in and upward, just time after time after time after time and time, and really doing these abdominal thrust just time after time after time after time until hopefully whatever they were choking on basically comes out, okay? Prevention's worth, you know, was it an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. You know, it's better not to do the Heimlich if somebody is a choking risk. Do the steps that need to be done so that you don't have to do the Heimlich. Cut the meat into small pieces. Feed them slowly. Have only half the teaspoon filled. Hot dogs and chicken, make sure they're cut into very small pieces. You know, because those are the two things that are notorious. But again, this was just a little talk on the Heimlich. I highly advise you to go ahead and get CPR certified with the abdominal thrust. This item here is just a little device, foam device, that for some people, if for whatever reason, their legs need to be scissored apart. This can go between their legs. The one leg can lay down this part, the other leg down this. It kind of fits up in between them. Like say if there's a real bad wound in the inner thigh and we need to keep the leg spread apart more so maybe more air could get in there. You know, it's just that type of device, that type of pillow. Okay, we're about at the, come back on me, we're about at the end of this disc, so we're gonna stop this and then go on to the next table here.
Huh.